All right, so here's video number two, the Eve introduction. I went over some of the different ship types and what they do. Caldari's missiles. I'm just going to break it down simple. Caldari's missiles, and they shield tank. Mimitar is projectiles and missiles, and they shield and armor tank, depending on the ship. Amar is lasers, and they armor tank. Galente is hybrid, and they armor tank. So I'm just going to go ahead and pick a faction here, just because she's Amar. And I click next. They have little nice intros, actually really nice little intros for when you create your character, worth watching. These are three different sub-factions to your faction. They really don't mean much. Back in the game release, they would give you different skills, but I don't think that's the case anymore, so it doesn't really matter what you choose. You just need to choose male or female. Let's choose a male. Actually, let's choose female. They're prettier. Click next. This is a new feature to Eve, relatively new, where you can actually see your character in game and stuff. I'm just going to randomize this stuff. I don't want to spend a whole lot of time, but you can really get some good customization here with this new system. So we'll go with that. I mean, you can fuck with their facial features, and it's a very much in-depth system. Go next. Here's your screenshot. You can adjust their eyebrows, make them look all funny or whatever. And you take a picture. Next. And there's your name choose. Let's see, choose name. I'll just say Exile Test Account. And family name, you can randomize it, whatever. Check availability, yes. Finalize, yes. Yes. And this is where you start the game, in a station. I'm going to show you a little bit of this new feature of the captain's quarters. You can actually see your player now. Used to, you couldn't see a full 3D representation of your character. You have a captain's quarters where you can basically interact with the environment, but all of the things that you can interact with are right here on your bar, so it's not really much, unless you're into the role-playing aspect, you know. Like, for instance, if I wanted to look at the journal, I click here on the screen. But I can also click it on the left side there. Same goes for corporation. You could click there on that left side, but it's also here on the left side tab. So not much in the way of unique player interaction with your character at this point. Now, once they add a new feature, you'll be able to walk outside of this door and go into a station and interact with other players. But that hasn't been implemented yet, so, and maybe it'll be worth checking out once they implement it. But you walk out here, here's your ship hangar. As of right now, I've just got a pod, but here at the bottom left, you got your ships, and apparently I don't have my starter ship. I don't actually use this. You can change and toggle this out. There's your pod. That's where your pilot lives. The kind of interesting thing is that the pilot gets inside this little pod, and it's filled up with amniotic type goo, and their ship is actually an extension of their mind and their body. So, as far as lore goes, there was some ancient race of people that showed these people this technology. Basically, humans found a wormhole at the edge of the solar system. They went through and they couldn't get back out, so they started a whole new civilization out in Eden, which is New Eden, where it takes place, Eve. And they've been out here for, like, I don't know, 40,000 years or something, created a whole new space race, blah, blah, blah. So I don't usually view my character because there's not much that I can do here that's different than just using these sidebars. So up here at the station services, I click enter ship hangar. This is the classic way that Eve used to look. And I've got my graphics turned kind of down. So yeah, there's tutorial stuff that you can do, but basically, I'm gonna bring something up here that's very important that everyone should know right off the bat. If you open up the medical tab and you look at your information here, you have clone type, skill points. This is really important because your skill points are what you train. So as you say, I go into my character sheet here, I want to train electronics. I will right click it, train now to next level. All right, I have another character in training, but if I'm training this skill, I get X amount of skill points per hour. And as that accumulates, my skill points here will go up. Now, right now, my medical clone can keep 900,000 skill points. Now, why that's important is because if I go out into 00 or NullSec or LowSec and I get killed and my pod gets killed, your pod is inside of your ship, so you have a chance to save your pod. Once your ship explodes, your pod is exposed. Then you have to get your pod out. If your pod dies and you have more than 900,000 skill points, then you will lose a percentage of those skill points, which is very, very bad because some of these skills take, months to train. So what you have to make sure of is that your skill points, which right now on my character sheet, top left, says I have 55,074 skill points. So I am actually good to go for a while. And once I pass 900,000 skill points, I have to upgrade my clone to a higher level. So in this case, let's say I made it to 1 million skill points. Well, I need to upgrade my clone to a clone that will keep 1.3 million skill points. If I don't and my pod explodes, I will lose 100,000 skill points if I have a million. So you have to always make sure that your clone is updated. And the easy way to imagine it, a lot of games use a cloning system because it's easy to explain the death penalties and stuff, is the clone that you're in now is a separate clone from the clone that's in your medical bay. When you die, if your clone is insured for that much skill points that you have currently, you will not lose any. So basically, you have to keep your medical clone updated above your maximum skill points that you currently have. Otherwise, when you die, you will lose some. And you do not want that to happen at all. So the clone type is basically, all these different Roman alphabet or whatever ensures your clone for as many skill points as you have. Always make sure that that's up to date. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video and start on the next one.